So this is the third part, and in this part I'll talk about the GD&T in detail. So let's get started. So we have already done the dimensioning for this part. Now we will do the GD&T. And to understand the GD&T step by step, I have another video in which I have explained the need of GD&T. I have explained the step by step approach to start the GD&T and to complete the GD&T. I have explained different ways to place the datums and to place the symbols inside the drawing. The link is given below in the description area and it will come onto your screen. You can watch this link to get the complete idea about the GD&T. Now in the same way, I will explain the GD&T for this part. So if you see this drawing, there are several dimensions having the limit tolerance, this and this dimension. Some dimensions are having symmetric tolerance and the rest of the dimensions are having the general tolerance. So the dimension controls the size of the part and the GD&T controls the shape of the part. So when you start the GD&T for any part, one thing you should always keep in your mind is what is the function of the part inside the assembly, how the part is playing inside the assembly. And to start GD&T, we first decide the datum. Now if you see this drawing, you have three datums, datum A, datum B and datum C. Now the datum A is the primary datum, datum B is the secondary datum, and datum C is the tertiary datum. Now how these datums are decided inside the drawing? And to understand this, open the part. So this is the part. And to decide the position and placement of these datums, there are two things we keep in our mind. The first thing is how this part is going to place onto the inspection table. And the second thing is fixing the three-dimensional movement of this part onto the inspection table. So if you place this part onto the inspection table, either you place this surface to the table or you will place this surface to the table. So either you will go with this position or you will go with this position. You cannot position this part like this onto the inspection table if you have your table down here. So based on that position, I placed my part like this. That means this surface is the datum A. So my first datum is datum A, which will be attached like this. So this datum shows that this part is placed using this surface onto the inspection table. Now the secondary datum, datum B, this datum. So when you place this part onto the inspection table, one directional movement is fixed. Now the two directional movement. So to understanding the function of this part and fixing other two direction, I will fix this axis. If that axis is fixed, then this part will not move in other two direction, and that is how datum B is decided. Now the datum C. Now if you see datum B, it is attached with this dimension. So if the datum is attached with the dimension, that means that datum is the center of the dimension, which is this center axis. So this clearly shows that datum B is this center axis. Now if you come to datum C, this is also attached with this dimension. Again, if it is attached with the dimension, that means the datum is for the center of this dimension and the center is this axis. So now if you see the datum B and datum C both are attached for the same center axis, which is practically wrong. You cannot apply multiple datums for the same axis or same plane. But if you see this portion carefully, there are two features available here. One is this feature and another one is this feature. So the datum B is for this center axis, which starts from here to here for this particular feature. And datum C is for this center axis, the smaller center axis for this feature. So there are two center axes. One is the smaller center axis and one is the bigger center axis for these two datums. Now once datum B is decided, I am controlling the position of this feature using this center axis, and that is why we have applied datum C for this center axis. So this is how the datums are decided. So now I have decided my datums. So let's place the datum first. And to place the datum, go to annotate. Datum feature symbol, select the surface and place the datum. You can move it down. Now the second datum, and that is attached with this dimension. So I will place like this. Now the third datum, which is attached with this dimension. So I'll place like this. So I have placed all my three datums. So there are different ways to place the datum and place the symbol. So if you watch my another GD&T video, then these things will be totally clear. Now the next thing is placing all the symbols, and to start the symbol we always start with the datum A. So the moment you decide the primary datum, datum A, that means you are going to place that part onto the inspection table using that surface. So once I have decided that I am placing this part using this surface has to be perfectly flat, and that is why we apply flatness to that surface immediately. So now you can see that you have the flatness here. Suppose the part is a cylindrical part, and that cylindrical surface is my datum A, then immediately we apply the cylindricity. So in this case my datum A is a flat surface, so we will go for flatness. So go for geometric symbol, select the surface and place the symbol. Later on you can go to the symbol and change the symbol. Now you can change the value, it is 0.02. I'll just move this dimension outside. I will move this down. So now I have applied the flatness symbol here. Now if you see this drawing, by seeing this drawing I can understand that this surface is datum A, but this surface is not having any functional requirement inside the assembly. The functional requirement is with this surface. Now if I can place this part using this surface onto the inspection table, I would have given datum A and flatness to this surface. But since this part cannot be placed using this surface onto the inspection table, I have given datum A and flatness to this surface. But practically my functional requirement is with this surface, and that is why I have added the parallelism to this surface. So if you can place this part using this surface, then it is better to apply datum A and flatness to this surface to avoid this symbol. But in this case, I cannot avoid this symbol, so I'll go for parallelism. I'll just select this surface and I will place like this. Now I'll just select this and move it outside like this. Come here, go to arrow style and say none. Again select this symbol and change the symbol, parallelism, change the value with reference to datum A, click outside. Now the next symbol I will place is this symbol, because this is also reference with datum A. So I have just placed this symbol because this was reference with datum A. Now my next symbol is this symbol. So go to annotate, geometric tolerance, select this dimension, change the symbol, perpendicularity, change the value, this is 0.1, add the symbol, then the material condition with reference to A, click outside. Now you move this dimension outside. Now once you have moved the dimension outside, you can reattach this datum to this box. Now this is done. Now the next symbol is this symbol, which is reference with datum B. So go to geometric tolerance and place your symbol somewhere here. Now this is the position tolerance. So go to position, change the value. Again this is 0.1. Add the symbol, the diameter symbol, then the material condition with reference to datum B. Now you cannot attach any symbol with a note, and that is why I have placed this symbol outside. So if I move this note somewhere here, my symbol doesn't move, and that is why when you place a GD&T symbol next to your note, you select this symbol, go to sketch and use relate to object and relate with this note. Now if you move this note, your symbol will also move. Now this symbol is again having material condition. So select your material condition. Now my next symbol is this symbol. So again I'll go to annotate, geometric symbol, and I will attach with this. Move this dimension outside. select this symbol and change the symbol. This is run out with reference to datum B. Now the next symbol is this symbol with reference to A and C. So go to geometric tolerance, select this dimension, change the symbol. Now the symbol is run out. Change the value 0.05 with reference to A and C. Now you move this dimension outside like this. Now again you can change the reference of this datum. So this portion is done. Now one symbol is coming with this dimension. Now this dimension is also having limit tolerance. So go to limit. Now change the limit. Now go to geometric tolerance. Attach with this. So this is also done, and this completes the complete GD&T, and I hope this video will be helpful. Now you can like this video, all the three parts, if the content is helpful, and I'll see you in my next video. Thank you.